Hey folks, Matt from MarioTheImage.com. We've got a viewer writing in. This is Luke. He says, camera choice. That's the heading on the email. He says, hello, my name is Luke and I am from Australia, living in Kenya. I'm wanting to buy a new camera to fit my needs of both video and stills. I've owned a D3100 for 6 years. So that's the Nikon D3100 3000 series. That's a entry level. My budget is around 800 euros for a body. I'm deciding between the X-T20 or the G80. I've even thought about getting the X-T100 and spending more money on lenses. Is 4K really worth the extra money, or should I buy a cheaper HD camera like the X-T100? It has 4K, but only at 15 frames per second, so pretty useless. Thanks, Luke. Okay, so thanks for your question, Luke. First of all, get the X-T20 over the X-T100. Here it is right here. There's my favorite kit lens with it, the 18-55 2.8-4, which is a fantastic, probably the best kit lens ever made. All metal, so smooth, always impressed when I pick this thing up. Great camera. You got the flip-up screen on the back, you got 4K, you get the 24 megapixel wonderful Fuji sensor. It does really decent 4K, and the focus system in here, even in video, is very close to Canon's dual pixel AF. Has a lot of ability to tweak it and customize it. It's a fantastic little package, especially for the deals you can get on it right now. I'll put a link below. You can check it out to the camera. The 50 f2 is on here right now, which is also a fantastic lens. This is a great setup to start with, the 18-55 2.8-4 and the 50 f2 if you want more of a portrait lens, a fast prime. The 18-55 is no slouch at the long end, shooting at f4, which isn't too bad with these faster sensors. But if you want more subject isolation, this 50 f2 is fantastic. Reason I get it over the X-T100 is the X-T100 is more of a beginner camera. The X-T20 is basically the X-T2, 90% of it anyways, in a smaller, lighter package at less cost. The X-T100 strips more features, and 4K, yes, in a nutshell, is definitely worth it. Whether you're shooting 4K, if you're getting into video, which you're saying you are, you're going to want to shoot 4K. That's where we are right now, and the future is going to be even more entrenched in that. Shooting 1080 right now, you're crippling yourself. Whether you want to come back later and post-process to 4K, because you can shoot 4K and output to 1080. That actually gives you a better file. You get the ability to extract stills from a 4K video, which I've done, and it's amazing. You get like 8 megapixel stills out of the 4K video. Can't do that with 1080. You need a very, very small image. And then just the ability to zoom in and crop and whatnot in video editing if you're exporting to 1080 is fantastic from 4K. So yes, 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 4K all the way, especially at this point in time. We're in the middle of 2018 here. Nobody's putting out new cameras of any quality without 4K. I was actually a little bit disappointed with Fuji that they crippled the 4K on the X-T100, but it is understandable because of the price. So I think what I would do, I would get the X-T20, and if budget, then you're wanting more lenses, what I would do it to begin with is the X-T20 and the 18-55. That'll do you very well, because it's a 2.8-4. Later, you can build up your lens arsenal with the 50 f2 and what other lenses you want from Fuji. The G80 is a great camera. I'm filming this with right now with it. If I was doing primarily video work, I would probably go with the G. Well, I have the G85 in Europe. It's the G80. And I love it for video. The X-T20 gets a little bit of the nod for photography. It is a smaller, lighter camera. It does have more resolution at 24 megapixels. It also has a better performing sensor, because we're talking about an APS-C sensor, which is bigger. You know, you got Micro Four Thirds, APS-C, and then full frame. So APS-C is going to give you a cleaner, better image. Not that the G80 is a problem. It's a very good camera. I've used it for professional work. However, the X-T20 is a notch above. So that's what I would do if I was you. I think I would go with the X-T20. If I was doing a lot of video work and just a little bit of photography, then I would get the G80 instead. Reason for that is, as solely as a video camera, I prefer the fact it does have the flip-out vari-angle LCD, and Panasonic has really nailed the 4K video. Where the X-T20 may excel in video over the G80, the G85, is the ability to have something similar to Canon's dual pixel AF, is better on the X-T20 than it is on the G85. But I usually am working in a studio situation for video most of the time, in this type of situation where the camera's on a tripod and I set the focus. I can control it here with my iPad. So I'm running the Panasonic app, which works very well. If you want to do that type of situation, then the G80, G85 is really the way to go. If you're doing more of a vlogging situation where you need the camera to be able to focus and follow you more smoothly, not as strong on the Panasonics, the X-T20 is going to be better for that. So that's what I would say. So I am kind of leaning towards the X-T20, but if you are doing a lot of video and in situations like this where you don't need the kind of Canon dual pixel AF style focus, then perhaps the G80 might be the way to go for you, just depending on your needs. Get out to the store, get them both in your hand, think about what you're doing. If you're doing a lot of photography and a little bit of video, then the X-T20. If you're doing a lot of video that's vlogging or handheld and you need that Canon style dual pixel AF type autofocus, X-T20. If you're doing a lot of work where you don't, you know, manual focus or you're on a tripod and whatnot and you're just doing a lot of video work where you don't need smooth, fluid autofocus, G85, G80 is the way to go. And throw it back to our viewers though. What do you guys think? Do you agree with me? Would you go with the X-T20 if you're mostly into photography and a little bit of video work? What about, you know, what I'm saying as far as the dual pixel AF? I think it's like Kleenex. Canon coined that term. That's why I refer to it for all the cameras now. I mean, that is Canon's branded name, but you know what we're talking about when we say that. Also a fantastic photography system, beautiful lenses. But again, the G80, the G85 is no slouch. So let us know what you guys would do in the comments below. Curious to hear your feedback. Let's help out Luke. Always great to get your feedback, your responses, your user reviews, your experiences shooting these cameras so that our viewers can get a rounded section of opinions, group of opinions when they're going to make their purchases. Thanks for tuning in. Thanks for your question, Luke. Looking forward to seeing your feedback, guys. And stay tuned. We'll be back soon here at artoftheimage.com.